So this one could go right here.
Good morning from NASA's Johnson Space Center. This is Mission Control Houston. You're looking at the International Space Station Flight Control Room as a team of flight controllers, which has been on console since about 7 o'clock this morning, U.S. Central Time, watches over all of the systems aboard the International Space Station. The team today is once again under direction of Flight Director Royce Renfrew in the blue shirt you see there. You'll hear conversations between this flight control team and the crew aboard the International Space Station. That conversation primarily from this room will be handled by Josh Matthew, you see sitting there alongside Royce Renfrew. This team will be on console throughout the daytime hours. They'll hand over to the next shift mid-afternoon to continue the uninterrupted coverage of Expedition 34's voyage aboard the International Space Station. That complex currently orbiting about 250 miles, statute miles above the Earth, having just moved into an orbital sunrise midway across the Pacific Ocean, having just passed high above the Hawaiian Islands on a southeasterly track that will take the station across the southern tip of Chile and Argentina before heading out across the southern Atlantic Ocean. From this vantage point, the station circles the Earth every 92 minutes, offering the crew an orbital sunrise and sunset about every 45 minutes or so. That crew aboard the International Space Station is in its 43rd day in space, 41 of those aboard the International Space Station, and 16 as the Expedition 34 crew, made up of Commander Kevin Ford, you see on the left in this view, and his two Russian colleagues in the center, Oleg Novitsky, who's serving as the TMA-06M Soyuz spacecraft commander, and also Yevgeny Tarelkin. Those two gentlemen on their first flights into space and, of course, their first long-duration voyages, they join Ford, who flew previously on a shuttle flight, STS-128. STS-128 flew back in August of 2009. The crew woke up today about midnight. They will head to bed about 3:30 in the afternoon. That's a typical length of day for the crew members. There's quite a bit going on aboard the station as the crew members have breakfast, and then just after that they'll gather for a daily planning conference with all the flight control teams around the world. That occurred about 1:30 in the morning Central Time, and then they split off and go in different directions to support their timelined activities. Commander Kevin Ford has spent the early part of his day with some maintenance tasks, water sampling tasks inside the aquatic facility inside the Japanese experiment laboratory. And he's also spending a much longer period of time on his day working on the fluid science laboratory rack configuration, which is located inside the European Space Agency's laboratory, Columbus. Russian crew members are conducting some routine maintenance activities in the Russian segment of the station. They're swapping out some filters inside the station with some new versions. Some low noise fans are being installed inside the Russian segment of the station as well. And the crew members, after that installation, taking measurements, obviously, to provide that data to the folks on the ground to assess the working operation of those new low-noise fans as well. They're also working on communications reconfigurations inside the MRM-2, the mini research module known as POISC. That serves as one of the docking ports on the International Space Station for visiting vehicles, primarily the Soyuz spacecraft. In fact, their Soyuz spacecraft is currently docked to that mini research module known as POISC. You see the Soyuz 32 or TMA-06M spacecraft. In addition to their routine timelined activities, obviously the crew also has their own health to be mindful of, and they have always timelined two different exercise sessions for each crew member, typically in the morning hours of their day and also in the afternoon, to allow them to maintain their cardiovascular and musculoskeletal systems for their long-duration stays in space before they return to the one-gravity environment here on Earth.